Greetings to all, I'm Brother Shmuel Tuazon, servant of the true God, marked by fire in my belly, prophesied the spirit of truth in the Holy Bible. Today, I have a topic to share to you. It's about the news I'm seeing right now that a country sent a rover or a machine in the moon and it landed there just a few days ago. And then they sent some videos and they're saying that our small spacecraft successfully landed on the moon. And then a rover or a small machine that will go around the moon has went out of the small spaceship and will walk. That rover will walk on the moon. Now, I'm gonna be direct to you, okay? There's many problems about this claim. Okay, so for you to understand my point, those listening to me, I want you to understand. I'm sorry, I need to talk on this level, okay? But I will try to explain it. I want to talk to you about binary. Binary, the technology they're using right now, it's always every day in your smartphone. How we communicate. Binary is 1-0 in programming. So a very, very long program like your smartphone or your computer, the program is made of gazillions of 1 and 0. The variations created color that you can see in your smartphone, and combining it creates images. So basically what your phone sending and receiving, it's digital, it's 1 and 0, but on gazillion times of arrangements. So I'm gonna, please bear with me, okay? Binary 1 and 0, before it became a program, decades ago, it is really an on-off switch. You know when you open your light in your house, on-off, your light on and then it off. So on is 1 and off is 0. That is before it became binary. It's electricity, 1 on, 0 is off. And then they discovered transistor. It can switch by itself. So 1 and 0, it can switch by itself. It's controlled electrically. And then they discovered to put so many transistors in a microchip. Right now, there's billions of transistors in one microchip. So it's billions of switches in a microchip. And so now they can make binary. They can send and you can receive by your phone and send binary. They transform it into wave. The 1 0 1 0 1 0 0 0 0 0 1, they transform into wave and you are receiving it in your phone and you are sending it. So now you can communicate and it transforms into calls, images, videos, everything you want. But we're talking about gazillions of ones and zeros here, and your phone can read it and translate it. Now, going back to the moon mission. A country send a machine in the moon, a robot. How far is the moon from here? According to Google, it's 385,000 kilometers far. That's far. 385,000 kilometers. How can you send a binary wave? How can you send a binary wave signal on that far? What technology is that? Another question is how the Earth is continuously in movement. It is rotating and revolving. And another thing is the moon is revolving against it. So, two objects rotating, two objects revolving. And then another question is, So the binary itself is a problem. The binary, how can you send the machine up there and it land precisely where you want it? I'm going to ask you a question. Is there a GPS there in the moon? How can you control such object on a predestined location on a moon? How? And then you are 385,000 kilometers away. The signal itself, how can you send a binary signal, a binary wave, that far? And how can that machine send back a signal? Power source, the signal it transmits, and the amount of data. How can you send it on 385,000 kilometers? I don't think even small packets of data can be sent or be received on a binary form, a digital form. There's no other form to send it. It's only by wave. And why right now we are on smartphone era, we are on my super microchips era. Why are you going to send there a box? A box like a cardboard box, and then you wrap it with gold foil, and then which looks like plastic, and then you put parts of RC toy car, and then the video is blurred on editing. I'm an editor. I know how to edit on computers. I know the effects, the blur. And another problem on that video, the moon craters are very small. Unbelievable. I'm gonna tell you one thing about distance. While you are already close to the moon, you cannot see the craters. You cannot. You cannot, because you will be inside the crater, you cannot see it. Oh my God. This, I don't know. I do not want to say bad things here. I don't know. Like, what I can say is, I don't know, maybe it's about money. Maybe it's about money. That's all I can say. But the wavelength, the communication, the binary is impossible. The trajectory is impossible. I know you people, some are engineers, mathematicians, professors, smart people. But can you imagine sending a binary signal 385,000 kilometers? and then the machine will send to you while the earth is spinning and revolving, and the moon is revolving also, and then you can land a machine and you control a rover on a exact spot on the moon without GPS coordinates. The maneuver itself, it's crazy. The thrust control, the maneuver. No. I understand machines, engineering, binary, electrical, computers. God made me understand it. It's impossible. Doesn't matter how smart you are, even the smartest person. Immediately I will say it's impossible. Not even how bright you are. How can you control a machine on that distance and trajectory? There's no way. And you receiving a signal from that machine, it's impossible. Even if we have the technology and the money and everything to do that, why are you going to send a crap box with a parts of the modern RCs are have much better parts. And why you should always wrap it in plastic? That is like you saying that people like they're not thinking. It's like you saying that the people are watching are not thinking, you know? No. It's not true. Okay, for me a person who knows knowledge about computer electronics, binary communication, engineering, measurements, no. It's impossible. Anyway, the Lord prophesied about me in the Holy Bible as the Spirit of Truth. So I'm just seeing these videos on the internet and I'm just telling to you what I know. And I have to say it because I'm a prophet of God. I have to say it. So greetings to all and glory to our Lord God for guiding us and telling us the truth always. And so this is my message today. And I have to end this video right there, right here. Okay, just like this. Because God is telling me to, that's enough. So glory to our God the Father, the Creator, where the true knowledge comes from. And glory to His Son, Lord Jesus Christ. Wait, just a warning to every leaders of the nations, the powerful people in this world right now. I'm advising you to only tell the truth to people, or tell the truth always. You know, like what's the point of lying to people? If you have big projects and you need funding, why not just tell them like, we use this money for military, we use this money for defense, or we use this money for healthcare. So why do you need to tell lies to people? You know, it's like it's because people right now, they understand the truth. People right now, they see the truth. People right now are smart people. So you know, it's like telling lies to people will just return to you as a shame, you know. When the people understand the truth. So to the leaders of this world, avoid lying. If you need funding and then you need to keep it a secret, then just say, you know, like you can give them a hint, but you can cover some things, but you can just tell them we're using defense, we need in military, we need in healthcare, or some other projects, or because we have a global cooperation, we need funding here, you know. You do not need to lie to people. So this is my advice, Brother Shmuel Toason, servant of the true God, marked by fire, prophesied in the Holy Bible. To God be the glory, and glory to His Son, Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.